I think this is the Black Watch. General Hospital, Antwerp, 1815. After a long silence, I embrace the opportunity of informing you respecting my present situation. About 12 o'clock at night, we turned out and at 2 in the morning marched from the city of Brussels to meet the enemy who were advancing in great force upon that city. About 3 o'clock in the afternoon of the 18th, we came up with them, and our whole force did not exceed 12,000 men, who were fatigued with a long march of upwards 20 miles, encumbered with knapsacks and other luggage. The day was uncommonly warm, and no water to be had on the road. However, we were still brought up in order of battle, the French being strongly posted in a thick wood to the number of 40,000 men, including cavalry and lancers, gave us very little time to look around ere the fight commenced on both sides. In an awful and destructive manner, they having every advantage of us, both as to position and numbers, particularly in cavalry, as the British dragoons had not yet come up. The French cavalry charged the British line of cavalry 3 different times and did much execution until we were obliged to form squares of battalions in order to turn them, which was executed in a most gallant manner, and many hundreds of them never returned. Still, they set up fresh forces, and just as often we beat them back. The battle lasted till it was quite dark when the enemy began to give way, and our poor fellows, the ones who were left alive, followed them as long as they could see, when night put an end to the fatigues of a hard-fought day. Thousands on both sides lay killed and wounded on the field of battle, and as the greater part of the action lay in cornfields, along a vast tract of country, many hundreds must have died for want of assistance through the night, who were not able of themselves to crawl away. I was wounded by a musket ball, passed through my right arm and breast, lodged in the back, from whence it was extracted by a surgeon in the hospital of this place.
Day of June, boys, 1815. Both horse and bull they did advance, most glorious to be seen. Both horse and bull they did advance, and the bugle haunted low, where the sons of France we made to dance on the plains of Waterloo.
His tail